Hey there, Indie Warriors. Tango's still here with a new review for you all. Today we'll be snapping pictures and exploring mysteries in the debt repayal RPG, The Good Life. The plotline for The Good Life is that your character, New York photographer Naomi Hayward, has an insane amount of debt. Something like 30 million pounds. I have no idea how she racked that up even after a few hours of playing. Possibly designer clothes. On the hook for money she doesn't have, Naomi takes an assignment to investigate the tiny little town of Rainy Woods, or as she calls it, a goddamn hellhole. Her first night in the town, however, she discovers all of the inhabitants can turn into cats or dogs. That, or the potion the witch gave her, caused some wild hallucinations. But the latter is unlikely, as Naomi herself acquires this ability to transform at will. So far, I've only played as a cat, but turning into a dog is also possible. Gameplay and controls are simple and straightforward. WASD to move around, Z to jump, Shift to sprint, left control to pull out your camera, and left alt to snap pictures. In cat form, Naomi can actually jump over walls, which, in my opinion, are perfectly climbable. Naomi just won't do it. She also seems to run faster, can climb, and can hunt small animals like birds, rats, and hedgehogs using the camera controls while in her feline form. There are a few other controls, but the game does a good job of giving you the essentials and gradually expanding your hotkeys and abilities. My biggest problem so far has been that I keep wanting to hit the escape instead of Z to back out of things. Rebinding is an option though, unless you're like me and too lazy to be bothered. Using the spacebar to confirm took me a little getting used to, but once I did, I found it to be much faster than the mouse as a way to navigate UIs like store inventories and Naomi's computer. Gameplay centers around fetch quests and investigations. Sometimes someone will ask you for materials, like harvestable plants or animal parts, and sometimes you'll get requests to take pictures of particular people or places. The world is massive, but there is a fast travel system you can unlock by visiting shrines and making an offering. Though I haven't ridden any critters myself, I've seen pictures of Naomi doing so, but mostly I've been getting around on my own four paws. Mixed in with this is the mystery of what's going on with these people turning into animals and the secrets of Rainy Wood that Naomi's employer is, for some reason, desperate to uncover. While completing quests, you'll meet all sorts of folks. Character designs run the gambit from local pub owner having a distinctly 1980s flair to the local smith and carpenter who talks like a knight and wears a full suit of plate mail. Then there's Elizabeth. She's a total sweetheart and frequently manages to creep the heck out of me, but I'm not sure exactly why. Might have something to do with her saying Rainy Woods is the happiest town in the whole world a few too many times. The game also has some classic harvest sim elements like cooking for yourself, which can give you boosts, a few farming plots to grow things in, which don't require any tending at all and grow super fast, some fishing, and some mining. There's an attack option as well with the E key, but she's not really doing anything more than kicking someone in the shin. No combos and fancy fighting here. I actually haven't found any fighting in the few hours I've played apart from breaking a few crates and barrels, but that feels appropriate for the vibe the game is going for. Graphically, I like the game. It's not crazy impressive or stylized, and it reminds me a lot of my time at Porsche, but it's got its own little quirks, like how everyone's eyes seem to be elongated diamond shapes. The colors are bright during the day, but not eye-bleedingly so, and at night it can be very hard to see. Music and sound-wise, there's not a lot going on, which at first made me think I was having sound issues, but no, there's just not that much in the way of background music, unless you're somewhere like the pub that has its own track. It's one of those quiet and chill games, which I love. Though I do feel like a little more background music wouldn't have hurt the game any. The game's sound design follows this minimal trend, so play is a very quiet experience. Not a bad thing in my opinion, but maybe a bit dull for some gamers. The voice acting has the same kind of quirkiness as the graphics. It's not stellar, but it's good, and often isn't what I expected. Final thoughts time, Indie Warriors. I like the game a lot, but I'm not head over heels in love with it. There's some replayability factor in that the game has three story routes at the time of this video, and I do plan to complete them all eventually. The mouse can be a little oversensitive, though that may be a hardware thing on my side as I just got a new gaming mouse, but the tiniest motions would turn the camera way too fast. Even at minimum speed settings, both in the game and out of it, I could still get turned around. If you're looking for platforming or combat, you're not gonna find it here. Haven't found any puzzles either, but the game isn't boring. It's quirky and funny and keeps catching me off guard, so yeah, I really like it. I highly recommend it for anyone looking for something chill and a little bit different. One final note. There is a known bug where the game loads and all you get is a black screen on Windows 10. Thanks again to Gamer Joe for figuring out the issue was a missing codec. It's not a hard fix at all, but I was frustrated by it. So, all said and done, what are your thoughts? Does the game look charming, or are you with Naomi and calling Rainy Woods a goddamn hellhole? A very special thank you to the following indie warriors: Mitchell Hall, Bunny, Kevilo, Bill T, Christian Cruz, Chris Jackson, Nathan Moore, Peach, Adriana Amato, CJR, PSC, Seacoil, Skepticism, Jen Rose, Jesse, CPM, Julian Colbus, JRS the 8th, Ray Lynn, and Mark Eman. Thank you all for watching I Dream of Indie. Your support helps to bring a voice to the voiceless ones in gaming. You can find info in the description below on other ways to support us, as well as a variety of links. If you want to catch future episodes, don't forget to sub and hit the bell. Until next time, Indie Warriors, good luck and have fun gaming.